Alright, guys. It was, you voted. Either Working Man or Mississippi Queen. Mississippi Queen won. Fucking love that song. It's good. It's week 14. These guys again. These guys. These dicks. Fuck you! And RG3. Fuck him. Fuck the Giants. Fuck all of them. Hate them. I was this close to a first round bye. But oh no, Jeff gets it. Returning champion. Gonna make a fucking 30 for 30 about how I went one fucking 2 years in a row. I know this is coming. What's even worse is that Mike might win. Because Mike's gonna fucking troll and get a Peyton jersey and we'll have two Broncos jerseys. But I think the all-time worst thing, in my opinion, would be Derek won. Derek, you're not gonna win. If you win, hate you. No, but seriously, Derek, I don't hate you. But when it comes to fantasy football, I hate you. Fucking trolling all day with his fucking, best in the West. Mr. Best in the West. Worst. Alright. Fucking, it's playoff time. Get your shit together. Been watching NFL channel forever now. All they talk about is fantasy playoffs. Been watching. Been learning. Can't do shit because everyone they say pick up the waiver wire, everybody already has. Our league's good. Their leagues are shit, apparently. There's not much help there. So I've been studying the tapes, watching replays weeks before. Got this. We'll go over who plays who in a minute, but let's get to this week's shit. Thursday Night Football is Broncos-Raiders, so really doesn't matter because, I mean, fucking Mike had all the Broncos, and that's where all his points came from. But, oh, wait, he's got a first-round bye, so this ain't going to do him any good. We'll go to the 1 o'clock games. Only two games worth watching is either going to be CBS or... By the way, I have Sunday off. Again, Sunday off, so same as last week. Come on down whenever the fuck you wake up. Do an all-day thing again. Jordan's got to go to work, and I don't know if Dale's working or not. 1 o'clock game, Bears-Vikings, that'll be good. Or, if that turns into a bloodbath, the game I want to watch is RG3 versus the Ravens. RG3's still trying to get them into the... You know what? I'm rooting for RG3. You know why? Fucking knock the Giants out! Done! Get rid of them! Fucking Packers kryptonite out of the playoffs. Guess what happens? Super Bowl win. Alright, 4 o'clock game. Everyone's going to want to watch this. I don't know if Dale took the day off. If not, he should. Saints-Giants. It should be good. Fuck Downs. Go Saints. Saints all day. Definitely want Downs to take a shit because that's who Derek has. And he's got, oh yeah, goddamn Ma Bradshaw. Or is that TJ? I think that's TJ maybe. Anyway. So that's the game of the week on Fox. And then the late game, which everyone should be here for, you got the Lions versus the Packers. Now, beat you once, hopefully gonna beat you again, but I don't know, it's scary. That's why I'm not gonna play Rodgers. And then Texans-Pats on Monday night. That's actually gonna be a solid Monday night football. Two just AFC powerhouses. That might be worth. I might want to take that day off. I got one more day to take off, and I'm thinking it's going to be that day. All right. So that's NFL, and we'll move on to the playoff picture real quick. Oh, number one in the NFC North. Oh, Green Bay Packers. Oh, so good. If the playoffs started today, we'd play the Seahawks. Fucking wow. Bears would play Giants, but in the hunt. Skins, Cowboys, Bucks, and Vikings could be. They're all 6-6. Giants lose, they all win. Boom. This is happening. AFC, which no one cares about. Texans clinched. Patriots clinched. Ravens would play Steelers. Colts would play Broncos. Bengals are really the only threat because, let's face it, the Jets, the Bills, and the Dolphins are not making the playoffs. It's the usual annual thing. They do not make the playoffs because they're shit. But let's go to last week. We can talk about, oh yeah, TJ destroyed my life. Great, thanks T. You had nothing to play for. Got my ass kicked. Fucking, I didn't have a bad week. 99 points is not bad. I have a big T-boner, beat the Lamb boners. Barely. Bullshit. Fucking fuck. Should've fucking times. You can't kick one more 40-yarder for me? Just one! I'll take a fucking tie! Just a fucking tie! God damn the Giants, I hate them. That number one team to hate now, the New York Giants. Seahawks, it's okay, I forgive you for that Monday night debacle. Still love Pete Carroll. Dream Team versus Chinny. Chinny now has the worst record in the league ever recorded. 1-11-1. So congratulations, Chinny. You set a record this year. So for your first year, congrats. Jordan's last year was, I think, like 2-12 or something like that. No. 2-11. My apologies. 2-11. So, 2-12. What am I smoking? He barely beat Chinny. Barely. By the narrowest of GMC Never Say Never trophies. 83-81. Team Cool Shirt and Seattle Sounders, they're just playing for position. Derek beat Chris 94-77. I believe... Oh, no. I don't want to give away later. Oh, wait. Denver Non-Downs, Bayou Bounty Hunters. About actually almost the exact same score as that last game. 93-74. Dale loses to Mike. God damn, Mike's... Mike's a fucking juggernaut. He's the juggernaut, bitch. So that was that. And let's move on to the trophies here. We got some... This is the last week where trophies actually counted. Worst all time, that's going to go to fucking Dale. I don't know how that... You know it's a good week when one of the big guys get it. 74 points. Sorry, Dale. You're worst all time this week, but that's also a good thing. Not for you, but for the rest of us. Everybody's scoring. Congrats to T, 113, most all-time, or best all-time, most this week. I get the come on, man. Should not have played Rodgers. Andrew Luck fucking tore it up. 28-14. So, yeah, should not. Discount double dicks. The picture's gone, but I'll find a new one. TJ earns this for beating me, or no, beating me and his spread, but his spread was 92. He had the most margin. Some of you barely beat your spread, but oh, Chris, you were in the Dave Chung. Where the fuck have you been, man? We haven't seen you since like October, or is it September? It was fucking September. Chris, where are you? You alive? Pick up your phone. I don't know. I didn't try calling you. I just keep texting you. Probably texting the wrong number. Anyway, if you watch the videos, come Sunday, at least Sunday night, unless you're working at like 5 a.m. like Chinny, and you have. It's okay, we forgive you. Good attendance goes to T. T out of nowhere comes on a Thursday. Scared all of us. Me, Dale, and Jordan were like, what? It was really cool having T there for Thursday night football. Had a lot of fun. So T, you earned the good attendance award this week. Bravo. Oh. I was like, who won the Anthony the Chinny Award? Chinny earns the Chinny, because no one is Chinny but Chinny, so no one could come close this week. I forgot what he said this week, but it was fucking hilarious. Me and Jordan were laughing. GMC, Never Say Never. I talked about that a little earlier. Jordan earned that 83-81 over Chinny. That was the narrowest win. Trash talking leader goes to fucking Derek for that stupid ass Downs photo. Fucking hate Downs. Fucking hope you lose to Cool Shirt. So I'm just fucking done with you. Fucking done. I hope you lose to Cool Shirt. Have Cool Shirt play Jeff, but then Jeff will probably beat Cool Shirt. No offense, Chris. Just, that's how the tables have turned. And, since this is the last week, the Superstar Trophy for the person who has the most stars, that really has no relevance to fantasy football, but I just made it because, I've had it since the beginning of the year, but person who had most stars this year with 38 stars was TJ. So congrats, TJ. I think this week probably pushed you over the edge because I did that trophy at the end, and you're only up 38-35 to the Dream Team, Jordan. Jordan got close. Jordan got real close. So congrats, TJ. You are the superstar. But let's go to what everyone's been waiting for. Week one of the playoffs out of three. First things first, I did write this down because Jordan and Dale, like, better talk about this so you don't want this to come back and bite you in the ass. Dog shirt playoffs are two games. Two games. Week one, week two. Week three doesn't... I don't know why ESPN has that bracket there. They just want people to continuously play, you know, through the playoffs. Week three, if you look in your bracket, week three does not count. You're playing this week. Okay? You're playing this week. And then next week, whoever loses the bowl, dog shirt, number 9 and 10, that's going to be you guys, number 9 and 10, So I'll go. Let's go over the consolation bracket real quick. For some reason, Jordan's playing TJ. I already texted Jordan about this. We're trying to figure that out. I don't know why that happened, but I think it's because of the three-week games. But going green with Nick Bailey versus the Dream Team. We'll see how that goes. So number 7 plays number 8, and number 9 plays number 10. Lamboners versus Strappin' Chins. Let's see how that goes. I hope Chinny doesn't win, because Chinny actually wants the dog shirt. God damn, Chinny. He actually wants to wear the damn thing. So I'm pulling for Chinny not to win it. Not to win this the dog shirt. Anyway, even though his projection 63 and Joe's is 125, Chinny needs to have a banner week next week. Probably not going to have one this week. But let's say Chinny loses and TJ loses. They play each other. Whoever loses that game earns the dog shirt next week. Just so we're clear. Okay, there's no third week for dog shirt. We've talked about this. We had a discussion while most everybody was here. So I don't want this to come back and bite me in the ass. You heard it here. You heard it first. Okay? We got winner's bracket. Denver Non-Downs, number 1 seed by, number 2 seed by. I have a big T-boner. God damn both of you. And then we have 4 and 5 playing each other. We have 4, the Bayou Bounty Hunters playing 5, the $5 footlongs. I'm going to get my ass kicked. Projections are solid for now. I hope we remain close as they are. But I doubt it. I have a bad feeling about this. Drew Brees is just going to fucking light up the Giants' D. Team Cool Shirt versus Seattle Sunders. 3 Seattle Sunders versus the 6 Cool Shirt. That should be good. Go Cool Shirt. If you win, I swear to God. Because you're going to get one of those nasty-ass, like, Russell Wilson jerseys or fucking Marshawn Lynch. If you get a Marshawn Lynch jersey, I think Dale will murder you in your sleep. Just saying. Just saying. So, hope you don't win. that's what it's looking like. And we'll see what happens. I'm nervous. It's getting pretty scary. We're going in. This is week 1, do or die. It's playoff time. Playoffs? Talk about playoffs. So, again, Thursday night, like the usual, respect the pause. Jordan's going to come after work. Feel free to show up around 8:30 if you want. Have a few beers. Sit around. There's always King of the Hill on. And Sunday, I'll be up by noon. So mosey on over anytime after 1 for the 1 o'clock games. I'll send out a text Saturday if I remember. If not, you'll get one Sunday morning. And then remember, we're still doing respect the pause. Text me if you're coming for the late game. If you're not gonna make it all day, that's fine. But if you're gonna come for the Lions game, just let me know so we can respect the pause and wait for you. But and maybe Monday, maybe, I don't know. We'll see. I got a day left, and I'm definitely gonna use it on Monday after fucking work until 5 a.m. last night. But, all right, guys, go Packers, fuck the Seattle Sunders. Dale, I love you, man, but I hope you lose. I got to win. Want the Bush Trophy. And good luck, consolation, guys. TJ, Joe, Chinny, Jordan. Jordan, of course. Sorry, Jordan. Hey, good luck, guys. You guys are playing for the coveted dog shirt. I heard Joe bark. All right, guys, take it easy. Have a good week.